ask me, oh, do you know, do you buy a single seat airplane? I've never owned a single seat aircraft because I always like going with somebody else. So I could have bought a MiG-17. I had contemplated MiG, actually. I looked at a MiG-21, it was the first thing, but there's nowhere to land them in Canada. Oh, I shouldn't say nowhere. The places you can land them in Canada, you can count on the fingers on one hand almost, right? So I ruled that out. Basically, I looked at a MiG-17, but there's very, very few MiG-17 two-seaters. So that was a challenge, and most of them are Chinese. So I was more looking for an aircraft that was really good. So, you know, I looked at the MiG-17, and but it has an afterburner as well. So I was looking at a single-seat aircraft with an afterburner, and I didn't really want the afterburner. And my friend said, why not? I said, well, an afterburner goes for an awful lot of fuel. He said, well, you don't have to use it. I said, do you know me? I mean, if it's there, I'm going to use it. And the problem is, it goes through a lot of fuel. I mean, it's something. These aircraft on their own go through an awful lot of fuel. So, through the process, I looked at it, and I started looking for the historical aspect of things, which is something I like as well. And if you look at it for the history, the era of the swept-wing jet fighter started with the MiG-15. It showed up over the skies of Korea in 1950, and nobody on this side of the fence knew it was coming. So that's kind of where the era started. And it took a while for North America to catch up with the MiG-15. The F-86, but it was several marks down the road before they actually started to catch up to the MiG-15. So that historical aspect of it kind of captivated my interest as well. That, in a sense, also associated with the fact that the Russian equipment is very, very reliable. They're simple in design. They don't add a lot of extra stuff that's not necessary. They put in what's necessary, the stuff that isn't, and they don't buy it. So the aircraft itself just operates. It's built like a tank. It's a very, very durable aircraft.